Hello everyone, and welcome to my Kirby Nightmare in Dreamland walkthrough. This is a remake of Kirby's Adventure for the NES. It is complete now with powers and extra secrets and harder ways to get to those secrets and stuff like that. But I know it's gonna be an awesome, grand adventure. Well, actually, it's kind of a short game, but it's still a fun game. So let's get this started. Of course, it's one player. Come on now, I don't do co-op. And level one is Vegetable Valley. We start out at one of these dealios here. As you can see, there's this weird wall in the way here, but we can go inside that door. Pressing the jump button multiple times lets you float in the air like that. Pressing the B button exhales your air, and holding down and then pressing the jump button will make you slide, and that's basically all I can show you until I get some powers. So let's go into the first level of Vegetable Valley and grab this waddle-doo. When you press the B button to suck him in like that, and then press down, you will digest him quite viciously, and you will gain its power. In this case, it's a beam. You press the B button to use that power, and shoot! That's bad! That's very bad! Whenever you take a hit from an enemy in this game, you lose your power instantly. Oh, I should have grabbed that guy to show you his power, but whatever. There's some Wildees and Bronto Berts and some Fire Guys, and I should have took his power, too. Come on, I want to show off some of the powers, dang it. Yeah, Spark! This will basically give you a little electrical field like that. It looks like the plasma from Kirby Superstar or Kirby Superstar Ultra, but no, it's just an imitation. Oh boy, you almost hit me there. I was expecting it to hit the ground there, but it went a little higher than I expected. This is the firepower. Just pressing the B button will let you shoot a fire like that. And pressing the select button, I think it is. Hold on a sec here. I just want to make sure this is joy map properly. Yeah, select button is, select button is the button that I have mapped to the X button on my Game Boy player here on the GameCube. So, yeah, I got a little confused there, but it is indeed the select button that lets you lose your powers like that. When you see your power fly away like that, you can just suck it back in like an enemy and then regain your powers. So, yeah, that's about it for this little explanation here. There's a whole load of powers to show off in this game, so that'll be pretty fun to... Oh, maximum tomatoes. They give you all your energy back. By the way, if any powers fall into the water, they immediately evaporate. Watch. Like that, and boop! You can't recover it when it goes in the water like that. So, yeah, don't let them fall into the water if you can't help it. And whenever you see this very, very flashy, very shiny goal like this, I don't know if it'll pick up on the camera because of the frame rate. You'll end up at this ending thing, this ending game here, and if you press the A button at the very lowest point of that springy launcher thing, whatever you want to call it, you'll fly high into the air. The goal is to get to the top, to get a 1-up or a bunch of 1-ups. I forgot what the actual prize is at the very top there. But I know second place, or second floor is like 5,000 points or something like that. But the first place one, or the highest one, is a 1-up or 3 1-ups. I kind of forgot what's in this game. When you go inside here, there's a little mini-game. This is a bomb rally game. This is kind of like Hot Potato in a way, in that you have to press the A button when the bomb is getting thrown towards you. If you win this, I think you get a 1-up. Yeah, baby! Oh, no, I don't think so. I don't think so, sucker. Oh, yeah, you're out. You failed miserably. And now a computer plays in his place. Well, come to think of it, they're all computers anyway, so what am I talking about here? Please don't send it back towards me. Blow up somebody, not me, though. Please, yeah! It's just between me and Yellow. Oh, yeah. Eye of the freaking tiger right now, baby. Okay, relax, calm it down. Do not hit me. Ugh, oh, no! I got second place! Well, I guess that's okay. I got 2 1-ups for that, so what is for... first place 3 1-ups or something like that? I don't know, but that was a good enough prize. Whenever you complete a level 100%, you'll notice that the door is yellow with an orange-ish star on the front there. And when a level isn't completed, you'll have a door that looks like this. It's orange-ish with a goldy flashing star. There isn't any secrets to find in these first two levels. Oops, I should say. I should say first two levels, and all the stages that are in those levels. So you can pretty much run through these stages safely without worrying about having to, like, go back and search for stuff and stuff like that. So if you want to, this is, well, I should say these first two levels are an introduction to things. And this is Poppy Brothers Senior here, and he just kind of jumps around and throws bombs at you. If you stay a decent distance away like this and just suck in his bombs and throw them back at him, he is not going to hurt you at all. He's a pretty dang easy boss. But, you know, it's level 1, so what can you expect from that? If you suck him in, you'll get the crash ability. This you can only use once, but if you use it, you can kill all the enemies on the screen at once! Yeah! There we go. And let's see. Oh, I forgot to mention, to enter doors, just press up. Yeah, that's just another mini tutorial there in my walkthrough. But that should be pretty obvious if you played any Kirby game ever. It's kind of self-explanatory at this point. So yeah, we're just going through the stages happily. Ooh, maximum tomato, me want! Yay! Even though I only had, like, one life missing, I still kind of wanted that. So, gimme! I should say die, monstrosity, not gimme. You don't give me any powers. Ooh, sword, I want that! I want some of that! I love the sword power. It's so swift, it's so fast, and here's the end goal. Okay, get ready to press the A button. Ugh! I think that was about right. It's okay, I guess. I got third place. I should say the third level of that bonus game. Boink! And watch the door change. There you go. And number three, here we go. Woo! And now you'll see what I mean about the sword being so swift. It can easily get through enemies quickly because you can, like, No, I want my sword! Because you can swing at them in the air while moving forward. It's definitely a great speedrun item, that's for sure. These guys give you the burning power-up. I should probably Oh, shoot. Oh, yeah, I knew that was gonna give me the sword because I grabbed two enemies at once. It'll always give you the power that you dropped and not the power that you knew that you grabbed, like, fresh. But this is the burning power-up. It's kind of like the fire power-up again in Kirby Superstar, except it doesn't... spew fire. That's the other fire power-up. Yeah, they kind of split the powers for this one. I don't know why they did that. Probably to make them less broken, so to speak. But the original Kirby Superstar game kept that, I should say, ambush! That was not fair at all! But the original Kirby Superstar game and the remake kept both those powers incorporated in one. Plus an extra power that if you press the B button while not holding any direction on the control pad, you can do like a little fireball drop attack, so to speak. I want that maximum tomato because of that dang ambush. Thank you. Oh, dang it, no! Why did you come back so quickly? You are not allowed to spawn so quickly. That's the end of the stage. Ugh! Ooh, second! Ugh! So close! And that'll open up a bunch of new stuff here. This is the enemy gallery. If you go in here, you're gonna see an enemy in here. This one in particular gives you the sword. And you can get as many sword power-ups as you want just by going inside that door there. This is... yeah. See that? That is very, very handy for getting good powers. Let's go to World 4 right away. And here we go. We are in a fall... oh, shoot! A fall-colored forest. It is quite beautiful. I gotta say, the graphics in this game are very, very nice for the Game Boy Advance. Oh, no, mooning me! No, this... don't you dare moon me! Oh, shoot! Don't you dare steal my pocket change, too! Ah, this game is not kid-friendly whatsoever. Digesting enemies within Kirby's bowels. Enemies that moon you quite sarcastically. Oh, shoot. No. And, oh, it's just not kid-friendly in the least, despite its cute appearance. Hey, stop. Don't do that. Well, I guess I'll take the beam. I'm not gonna get that other power in time. And what is beyond this door? No, evil caterpillars! Or whatever the heck that was. I think it was a caterpillar that does that. They roll up in a ball and just, like, really ram themselves into quickly. Yeah, that looks like a type of caterpillar. Come on, there you go, do the ball thing. Woo, look at it go! And there's a bunch of waddledees attacking you from above. The most dangerous enemy in Kirby history. No one is gonna get that reference. That item right there will make you invincible, and will make... wait, it doesn't make you... I was gonna say it makes you a little faster, but I guess that's not the case. I guess that's only in Kirby Superstar and Superstar Ultra. And in Kirby 64, that's the end of the stage again. Yeah, these stages are pretty quick this early in the game. But hey, that's to be expected. This is level 1 Vegetable Valley, after all. And here is the boss that's coming up. This door, it'll be opened up later. It will allow you to go back to any world you already finished whenever you want to, if that door is open for you. So that's something to keep in mind. Oh my god, it's Wispy Woods! No! All you have to do is just stand here and just keep mashing your B button if you've got a power. And Wispy Woods will be down. If you don't have a power, you can suck in the apples that she shoots at you from the ceiling here like this. And then just throw them back at her like that. Or I should say it's a him, or it's a her. I think it's a her, actually. I'm not actually positive about that. It's the world's greatest mystery. I think since I did level 1, I think that's all I'm going to be doing in this part. Just to keep things organized. I'll probably have to split up levels in multiple parts later on. But just to make things easier for you, I'll just do it like this. So, that about does it for this part. And I'll see you in the next part, where we start level 2, Ice Cream Island. Bye-bye.